Gordon Brown, leader to be, sits and frowns, shafted by Tony. Prudent and wise, slightly strange eyes, always looks down, that's Gordon Brown. Gordon Brown, he got his wish, but he still breathes like a goldfish. Don't try to smile, they'll run a mile. Stick to your frown, you're Gordon Brown. Gordon Brown looked like he'd won. Now we're close to a rebellion. Treasury waste, data misplaced. Get out of town, James Gordon Brown.
The House has noticed the Prime Minister's remarkable transformation in the last few weeks from Stalin to Mr. Bean.
Can I ask you, really, are you one of those who hates Gordon Brown?
You know what, I'll tell you something now, I'm a very open, I mean, I'm not the best looking person on this earth yet, but I hate that guy so much, I've just noticed bad habits. I mean, when he talks, he takes, like, breath like a goldfish. I just can't stand the way he even looks now.
Really?
Some of the stuff he's done on, you know, as soon as he's come into power, yeah, it's just, you know what, when I see him on the channel, I just change the channel, and I hate it when he talks, because he takes his deep breath every couple of minutes.
I'm not a proactive Prime Minister, I'm a reactive Prime Minister. What I do is manage crises like foot and mouth or floods or terrorism. And in order to manage a crisis, I have to create one in the first place.
I'm just behind you.
Quentin Letts, Daily Mail. Passing over your disgusting suggestion earlier that journalists don't take terrorism seriously, can I ask, in yesterday's meeting...
I didn't say that, by the way.
Yes, well, you certainly... That was what I understood. In yesterday's meetings, it's a serious matter. It's a disgusting suggestion.
But I know Brown is a little tiny dot on this world.
Okay. I mean, when he talks, he takes, like, breath like a goldfish.